from Mubtaker and up there High Chaparral. Also there is Doyen near the inside, and Diegene is searching for a handy position. Back in the field is Chris Kinn, who's got a pretty handy posse too. Mubtaker's trapped out wide. Ange Gabriel is just behind them. Dalakhani settling on the outside of the field, and further back then is Bolinerik as they go through the first couple of furlongs. And there's Vinnie Rowe on the outside, inclined to pull a bit, and Bolinerik is just behind him. But Diapore is the leader as they head over the side now. They've got just over a mile to go. Two lengths in front of the other pacemaker, First Charter. Then on the inside next is Black Sam Bellamy. Another shot there of Vinnie Rowe out wider. And also there in the green jacket, that's Dalakhani. But it's Diapore the leader from First Charter and Black Sam Bellamy. Up there too is Mubtaker, the outside. Doyen is there on the in the centre. High Chaparral's got a good posse. Ons Gabriel is back in the field. Out wider then is Vinnie Rowe. Chris Kinn is right there in the centre as they continue their journey over the side now towards the seven furlong marker in the arc. It's Diapore who shows the way from First Charter. Black Sam Bellamy getting up on the inside, and you can see back in the field Bolinerik with Dalakhani, who's about 10th of this stage. Black Sam Bellamy has got through on the inside of Diapore at this point. Up there too in the white cap is First Charter. Mubtaker's wide. Then High Chaparral with a good run in the centre is Doyen, followed then by Vinnie Rowan Black, and back in the field is Bolinerik. Then Chris Kinn the inside from Ons Gabriel. Dalakhani, who's well back in the field with Policymaker and Diegene for Germany, taken to the outside. Racing up the false straight now. And it's Black Sam Bellamy showing the way, joined by Mubtaker. Then on the outside is Bolinerik with Vinnie Rowe in the centre. High Chaparral now being positioned and trying to get off the fence. Dalakhani is coming there, cruising on the outer. Followed then back in the field by Doyen and Diegene to the outside. In the home straight, in the arc. And the leader, Mubtaker, the far side. Here's Dalakhani with his run. High Chaparral's got room now, but he's going to make up a length or so on Dalakhani. It's Mubtaker who's gone for home with a furlong to go. Dalakhani's the danger on the outside. Doyen is starting to fly home now from High Chaparral, but Dalakhani takes it up with a half furlong left to go. Dalakhani, Christophe Simeon from Mubtaker, who's fighting back, but Dalakhani wins the arc. Dalakhani wins the arc for the Yaga Khan. Alan de Ruyter Frey and Christophe Simeon. In second is Mubtaker. Third is High Chaparral again, followed by Doyen, then Vinnie Rowe, then Black Sam Bellamy and Diegene, followed then by Bolinerik, Ons Gabriel. They're followed back in the field by Policymaker, then First Charter, who's finished with Chris Kinn, and Diapore, the early pacemaker, is turned off. He punches the air with delight. The young Belgian, Christophe Soumillon, and shedding a tear of delight too, as number 8, Dalakhani, owned by His Highness the Aga Khan, trained by Alain de Ruyter de Prey, and ridden by Christophe Soumillon, has won the Prix de l'Arc de Triomphe. Second number 1, Mubtaker, owned by Hamdanel Maktoum, trained by Marcus Trigoning and ridden by Richard Hills. What a race he ran. And third number 4, High Chaparral, owned by Michael Table, trained by Edna O'Brien and ridden by Mick Canan. And fourth is number 10, Doyen. Let's see them go to the line. Dalakhani winning it by about a length, maybe a little bit less, from Mubtaker. Then a gap of 4 or 5 lengths to High Chaparral. Third again. Doyen, who loomed up, goes on for fourth. Vinnie Rowe, a good run for fifth. Then in sixth is Black Sam Bellamy. In seventh, Diegene. In eighth is Bolinerik. In ninth is Ange Gabriel. And let's see another angle as they cross the line. An aerial shot of Dalakhani, who was always going well. He beats Mubtaker. A very confident ride by young Christophe Soumillon, who had to come from stall number 14, the extreme outside. Not the easiest of tasks. And you can see the French camera coverage during the race was intent on keeping its eye on this horse and this jockey. That was Dalakhani and also Christophe Soumillon. They certainly paid plenty of attention to him during the race. And you can see how far back he was. But when they came up the false straight, he improved his position. Dazzling Dalakhani, doesn't that say it all? He then was poised on the home turn, in the home straight. It was then a matter of just wearing down Mubtaker. But there is the winner. That's number 8, Dalakhani. Second is Mubtaker. And third, High Chaparral.
What a wonderful performance. Dalakhani proving himself here on ground that we thought might just blunt his speed, but Mubtaker's run a sensational race as well. So this fresh strip of ground, not as soft as we feared it may be. Christophe Soumillon travelling beautifully there in about fifth position, moving up on the outside. And when he pressed the go button, my word, this horse can go.
Oh, he can quicken all right, and he can quicken on soft ground as well. That was the big doubt before the race, but there's no doubts now. Look at him just, he changes his hands and away he goes. And what a great race Mubtaker ran as well. Richard Hills, he was always cruising well. He was on the outside. He was always in daylight. So he decided to let his horse go as soon as he got in the straight. And he's just finished second. And Dalakhani is the only horse with a class to get by him. It's a great performance here. And it's just proved to everyone that he can handle any going.
A third win in the arc for the Aga Khan. A first for Christophe Soumillon, this young Belgian jockey who said beforehand is so confident, and confidence travels through the hands to the horse itself. Dalakhani's got ability. Look at him with his ears flat back, really stretching for the line and stretching to get past Mubtaker. And he did it. He did it on the day that really counts. And the French crowd here are going absolutely mad for the favourite. They adore this man, Christophe Soumillon. They love this horse. He's punching the air, and he'll go down in front of the grandstands and milk up the appreciation.
It's Roy Dupre, the trainer. It's his first arc, and it's the Aga Khan's third. So it's a great day for everybody involved with those green and red colours.
Ray, Willie said there how well Mubtaker's run, but what about High Chaparral, third again? And was he unlucky, do you think, or can you just put it down to two horses who are better on the day?
Well, I think two horses better on the day. I think Mick had a nice run round. He more than likely wanted a bit of a room sooner than he got it, but in the end, I don't think it would have made the slightest bit of difference to the result. The best horse in the race, great run by the second, a fantastic race.
Okay. Well, let's get a word from Richard Hills, who's finished second.
A heroic performance from Mubtaker, and Richard, he's given you a hell of a ride.
Yeah, he's a good horse, and he's got a big heart. He was just a bit fresh with me, and he's just running a little bit keen going down the hill, and it got me on the quarters of first chart, and I had to just pull him off, and I was giving away a bit of ground. But, you know, in this ground, if you've got a horse travelling, you've got to keep going forward with them, you know. But it just shows, you know, what a brave horse he is.
Well, he showed his heart, because it seemed as if when Dalakhani challenged him, he actually picked up and tried to go with him.
He tried to give him another go, but he was too strong. I don't know how far we're in front of the third. I didn't look.
Well, it was a long way back to the third horse.
Shame Dalakhani ran, eh?
Thank you.
Well done, Richard.
But what a good thing that Mubtaker ran, and there was a lot of doubt about that. And Christophe Soumillon there taking the congratulations of the other jockeys. Thierry Janet was saying well done to him there. So too was Frankie Dettori. And Christophe, who is heading for his first champion jockey title here in France. I think he's ridden 163 winners now so far this season. But this, the biggest and the best of them. And you can see him there standing up, saying to the crowd, come on, give us a cheer.
Well, it's a French win, so they like winning this race. And, of course, this horse was actually trained for this race.
The excitement, I think, getting to the cameras a bit. The picture's freezing there slightly, but Dalakhani is about to come into the winner's enclosure, and you will hear a roar that you very rarely hear on any race course in Europe, because you saw the cameras all piled around the Aga Khan and Alain de Roy Dupre before the race. They were all expecting this. The horse was a very short price favourite on the French tote, and that all controlled by weight of money. A lot of the punters here will have backed him, but if you took him on English prices, you'd have got 9-4. But here into the winner's enclosure comes the winner of the 2003 Prix de l'Arc de Triomphe, and Christophe Soumillon is in floods of tears. He's thrown his hat into the crowd, and he is milking this in style. Christophe Soumillon had been talking about this horse earlier in the season and just lavishing praise on him, saying the horse is a genius. Every time I think about riding him, I get emotional. I'd forgive him absolutely anything. Well, the only thing they've ever had to forgive him is being beaten by the Aga Khan's other horse, Alamshar. And you wonder, if he'd run Alamshar in the race today, what would have happened? I think he'd have had first and second is probably the answer. But Christophe Soumillon, I don't know whether he's going to get his hat back. I hope so, because he might just need it later in the day. But he said he's a genius like no horse I've ever ridden. The first time I rode him was a year and a half ago. He was very special, very mature, very advanced in his head. He said, I adore him. He's good every morning. He's never grumpy. He says he's above all others and particularly intelligent horse. And look at him there. He has got an intelligent head. He knows he's done something special today. And Christophe Soumillon saying to the crowd, you clap this horse because you may never see one as good as him again. And that has to go down as one of the great arc performances. Yes. You think of Pantelab.
It was one of the great. This is another real great. This is just pure, pure class, pure brilliance. It's everything you can say that is good in a racehorse. You got it. Look at this guy here. He's just hardly run a mile and a half. And he's given his all, and look at him taking it all in. He's saying, what's all the fuss about? I only just went a mile and a half and beat all the rest.